A soccer stadium holds 40,000 spectators. Based upon past records, if the ticket price is $15, the attendance will average 28,000. If the ticket price is $12, the average attendance will be 34,000. If the attendance is linear related to the ticket price, what ticket price will maximize ticket revenue? What will the attendance be? And what is the maximum revenue? So there's a lot going on here, but we first have to understand that the revenue from the ticket sales is equal to the price of the tickets times the quantity sold. And the quantity sold is a linear function based upon the price of the ticket. So we want to find the quantity function, Q of P, which because it's a linear function, we can write as M, the slope of the line, times the input P, the price of the ticket, plus B, the y-intercept of the line. We can find the equation of this function because it's linear using the information given, where one point would be when the price is $15 and the quantity is 28,000, and the other point when the price is $12 and the attendance is 34,000. So once we find Q of P, we'll have the revenue function that we want to maximize. We will have R of P, revenue function is equal to the price of the tickets times the quantity, which will be our function Q of P. So we'll have the revenue function in terms of P, which we can then maximize. But our first step is to find Q of P. Let's go ahead and do that on the next slide. So we'll first find the slope of the line using the slope formula M equals Y sub 2 minus Y sub 1 divided by X sub 2 minus X sub 1. The difference in the y values will be 34,000 minus 28,000 divided by 12 minus 15. And this comes out to negative 2,000. So we know that Q of P is equal to negative 2,000 P plus B, where B is the y-intercept of the line. So now we'll find the y-intercept, or B, using one of these two points. Let's go ahead and use this point here. So if the price is 12, that means Q of P must equal 34,000. So Q of 12 would be equal to negative 2,000 times 12 plus B, which must equal 34,000. So here we'd have negative 24,000 plus B equals 34,000. So adding 24,000 to both sides, we have B equals 58,000. So now we have Q of P, or our quantity function, in terms of the ticket price P. Q of P is equal to negative 2,000 P plus 58,000. Now remember, our goal was to find the revenue function R of P, which is equal to the price of the tickets times the quantity sold, which is Q of P. So now we have our revenue function, R of P equals P times negative 2,000 P plus 58,000. Let's go ahead and distribute here. R of P equals negative 2,000 P squared plus 58,000 P. Now that we have our revenue function in terms of P, we should recognize that this would be a quadratic function, and since the leading coefficient is negative, the graph of our parabola would open downward. So if we find the vertex of our parabola, that'll tell us the ticket price that will maximize revenue, and then the function value, or y-coordinate, will give us that maximum revenue. So let's find the vertex of this quadratic function on the next slide. Remember, the vertex for a quadratic function in general form are this form here. The x-coordinate would be negative b divided by 2a, and the y-coordinate would be f of negative b divided by 2a, or in this case, r of negative b divided by 2a. So looking at our function, notice that a is equal to negative 2,000, and B is equal to 58,000. So the x-coordinate of the vertex, or in this case the p-coordinate, would be equal to negative b, which is 58,000, divided by 2 times a, which is negative 2,000. This is equal to negative 58,000 divided by negative 4,000, which is equal to 14.5, which means a ticket price of $14.50 will maximize the revenue. To determine what that maximum revenue is going to be, we'll have to evaluate the revenue function, or R of p, when p is equal to 14.5. So we'd have negative 2,000 times 14.5 squared plus 58,000 times 14.5. And to save some time, I've already evaluated this. It comes out to 420,500. Which means the maximum revenue from the ticket sales is $420,500. Now, the last question we haven't answered yet was how many tickets would be sold, and that would be the value of Q of P, or Q of 14.5. Remember, our quantity function was here, Q of P equals negative 2,000 P plus 58,000. So we want to find Q of 14.5, which is equal to negative 2,000 times 14.5 plus 58,000, which is equal to 29,000. So at a price of $14.50 per ticket, which is the price that will maximize revenue, 29,000 tickets will be sold based upon this model. And as a last step, we can check our work graphically. If we were to graph our revenue function, we could check to make sure that our vertex would have an x-coordinate of 14.5 and a y-coordinate of 420,500. So here's the graph of our revenue function. Here's the vertex, and notice how the price, or the p-coordinate of our function, does look like it's 14.5, and the y-coordinate also looks like it's 420,500. So this graph does verify that our work looks good. I hope you found this helpful.